This morning in family time, it's still April vacation week for most students. Did you hear the sigh in my voice? It's still April vacation week for most students in Rhode Island.
But if you're looking for something fun to do with the kids, you may want to check out the interactive show at Providence Children's Museum that will really blow their minds.
Absolutely. And joining us this morning to chat about these mad science experiments, Megan Fisher. She is back along with Leah Pilbeau. No reptiles this time, no snakes this time.
No snakes today. All right, a lot of fun, though.
All right, let's talk about some of the experiments that you can see this week at the Children's Museum.
So today we have a show called Mad Science, and there are performers who are doing some mesmerizing science experiments exploring air and pressure with our audiences. And so they'll actually invite kids from the audience to join them on in the show and participate. So they're going to do some things with hot air balloons and other experiments. We wanted to bring some activities today that are similar.
Yeah. We want to participate with you today. And so Leah, take us through the first activity.
Sure. Well, first we have some things that you can make on your own outside of the museum, too. So we've got kite making. I don't know, Megan, if you wanted to talk about your kite.
Yes, at the museum, we often bring in special activities and performers, but we also do a lot of activities that using everyday materials that families can try at home, and so we really want to leave people with that message. So you can make a kite simply folding a sheet of construction paper, some tape to fasten it, and a straw.
Some streamers, which I'm sure
they have. Make it look good, punch a hole with a string, and then you need some heavy wind to help this fly.
Today may be a good day. Today might be a perfect day for it.
Yeah, so that's a really fun and easy one to try at home. And then also pinwheels. So I don't know if you want to give this one a try.
Okay.
So this one's really simple, too.
They used to make those in school all the time, and I could never make one of those.
Go ahead, give it a whirl.
All you need to is a square of construction paper.
I'm just going to stand here and do this.
Cut on the diagonal about an inch from the center, and then you just fold over the tabs one at a time. And you can use a push pin or a straight pin to fasten it to the eraser of a pencil, and you have
an easy enough to do.
Oh, very simple to do at home.
Look at how it's attached on the back there.
Yeah.
Very simple.
Yeah.
All right. And so we're going to be making these fun things. And
At the museum, our exhibit team actually built this giant wind tube. And then using, again, everyday materials. You said summer's coming. You've got your berry crates, coffee filters, anything you want to reuse and make a little flyer out of. And then...
And this is something that will be at the museum today,
This won't be at the museum today, but we do have an exhibit with air tubes. So Lou's going to demonstrate some of the ones she's made.
Okay, these are just some things I made, an old plate and streamers.
So some things fly well, some things fly less well, and so kids will get to experiment with materials and see what will respond to the currents.
That's fun because then you can each make your own. There it goes.
Oh, that was a good one.
Oh, thank you.
Whoa, there it goes. Let's see how this one goes. Here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Pretty sweet.
Well, that looks like indoor skydiving where you're just kind of floating and enjoying it for a little while.
That's a perfect one.
Thank you.
But that's so nice. I mean, it's a way for kids to, like you said, to get involved. And to be creative.
I'm going to throw some feathers in a berry container here and see what happens.
And so you can look around your house and see what materials you have. You know, coffee filters and the berry baskets are really easy things, the paper cups.
Not as good as mine.
This did not work as well. Let's put the kite in there. And Megan, other great activities happening all week long, right?
So tomorrow we will have farm animals in the museum's garden. And so we'll have some sheep.
Stuck. You are ruining my fun.
I'm trying to fly a kite.
We teach sharing at the museum.
Okay.
Sharing is, well, we probably should learn a little bit about that, too.
There it goes.
Thanks, ladies.
Hey, there it is.
It's working.
Flying a kite. All right, if you want to check out the mad science fun happening at the Providence Children's Museum this week, we'll post all the information you need on the Roadshow page at WPRI.com. Oh, there it goes.